In this video, we'll be looking at things to make with coffee. There are 5 things we are showing on how to make with coffee. Go ahead and watch this video. Let me know what you think. Hit the like button. These recipes are from Gemma's cookbook. I will be linking her channel below. And also, these have been made by my daughter who loves, loves, loves. She has taken the recipes but she has modified it. So please do check the videos because they are not exactly the same. They are also been modified. So let's get started. This is Lata from Indian Mom Vlogs. This channel is all about simplifying housewife, parenting, minimalism, and also we will be adding a beauty series very soon because I have subscribed to some beauty boxes and I would like to share them with you. So let's get started.
Let's start the 5 things to make with coffee challenge with coffee jelly. Here we are taking 1.5 teaspoon of agar-agar. Mix it with 2.5 cups of water. Mix it thoroughly and then we'll be bringing it to a boil. Make sure that the agar-agar dissolves thoroughly in the water. We don't want any lumps. We don't want it sticking to the bottom. Otherwise, it might burn. So once you feel that everything has dissolved properly, bring this mixture to a boil. This is just water and agar-agar, nothing else. We are stirring it because it might stick at the bottom and burn. So once you've brought it to a boil, you just need to add in 5 tablespoons of sugar and 2 tablespoons of instant coffee powder. We have used Nescafe. Just mix that up thoroughly and then stir it till all the sugar dissolves. There should be no lumps and nothing sticking to the bottom, else it'll burn. Just bring it to a quick boil once more and switch off. So this looks done. So we switch off and we are going to put it in a tray and let it cool. Once it cools, it will set into a jelly. This is a really very quick, very easy. It can be used to top on many of your desserts. It looks very delicious. It is delicious and it is such fun. Okay, in the 5 things to make with coffee challenge, this is coffee cookies. We've taken 1/3 cup butter, 1/2 cup of brown sugar, 1/2 cup of white sugar. Mix it in nicely. The more you mix, the more the butter becomes softer and everything just mixes in very nicely. Make sure you get this mixed in thoroughly. Next, we'll take the wet ingredients. Here we have 1 tablespoon of milk, 1.5 teaspoons of vanilla and 1 egg. Now, once you have mixed that up thoroughly, add the previous butter, brown sugar and white sugar mixture to this and stir it in. It will nicely blend, all of the ingredients will nicely blend in. Next, we will get started with the dry ingredients. This includes 2 cups of maida or all-purpose flour, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 1/4 teaspoon of baking soda, 1/4 teaspoon of baking powder and 2 tablespoons of instant coffee powder. We've used Nescafe. Once you've mixed that in thoroughly, now add it to the wet ingredients a little by little and make sure you mix it in very well. We don't want any lumps of any kind. Everything should be even. Once you have mixed it in thoroughly, we will be keeping it aside for at least an hour. It's best to keep it in the refrigerator because that'll make it firm so that we can roll out our cookie dough. So now you can see that the dough is ready. It's nicely formed. We are going to put it in the refrigerator for at least 1 hour. After 1 hour, we'll roll out around 1 inch sized balls, lay it out on your baking tray and see how yummy they turn out. We just microwaved it for 3 minutes and it turned out really good. Coffee cake in a mug. For this we need 1 egg, 2 tablespoons milk, 1 tablespoon veg oil, 3/4 teaspoon instant coffee powder, 1 teaspoon of hot water, 4 tablespoons of all-purpose flour, 1/4 teaspoon of baking powder, 2 tablespoons brown sugar. So let's get started. Let's mix all the dry ingredients together, which includes the all-purpose flour, the baking powder, brown sugar and a pinch of salt. Now we are breaking an egg and adding it into a bowl. In this bowl we already have 2 tablespoons of milk and 1 tablespoon of vegetable oil, and then mix it thoroughly so that everything is blended very well together. Add 1/4 teaspoon of coffee powder to 1 teaspoon of hot water. Mix this very well. This is the actual coffee flavor. This is all that is needed to get that coffee flavor. It's really very simple, very little, and tastes very good. Add this coffee, a strong coffee mixture which we have prepared, to the liquid, the wet ingredients. Mix it up so that the coffee mixes in really well, and then mix in the dry ingredients slowly, making sure that there are no lumps at all. Mix it thoroughly. Microwave it for 3 to 5 minutes. Top it up with some coffee syrup, which we will be preparing next, showing you how to prepare. In the 5 things to make with coffee challenge, we are making coffee syrup. This is probably the easiest. We have added 1 cup of sugar to a pan. Then add in 1 cup of coffee water, which has been prepared with 1 cup of water plus 3 tablespoons of coffee. Then add this together. Stir it in and boil it. Once it's boiled, add around 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla, bring it to a boil and then cool it. You can save it in any container of your choice. You can use this for cold coffee. You can use this as a topping for like coffee cakes in a mug, which we just saw. So there are many uses for this syrup. Just make it once, I cool it and save it in the refrigerator, and you can use it again and again. So here it's come to a boil. So we're gonna switch it off right now. Add in half a teaspoon of vanilla essence. That gives it a kind of a nice flavor.
Make with coffee challenge. We are making cold coffee, so add some chocolate syrup. We are using Hershey's syrup. Now add the coffee syrup which we had made in this video. We have shown you how to make that. Pour in some cold milk, and your cold coffee is ready. Give it a quick stir. If you want, you can top it with some chocolate shavings. So this is your cold coffee. It's instant and it's ready. It was the things to make with coffee challenge. This challenge was hosted by Ingrid from Mia and the homeschool. I'll be linking the playlist below. Check the others who are participating in this challenge. And thank you and see you. Bye-bye.